Now, let's take it beyond that. If we use the very same scientific discipline for growth statistics, go back just 41,000 years ago. 41,000 years ago is approximately the time, according to evolutionary theory, that Homo sapiens sapien arrived on the scene. That's modern intelligent man. That's the best that ever was. That's the premier exhibit of the universe. Man with his big brain and his functional hands, his upright gait without inhibition. Modern Homo sapiens sapien, modern intelligent man, about 41,000 years ago. Followed the very same population growth discipline. That would mean starting with just two people 41,000 years ago. The number of people alive on planet Earth should be 2 times 10 to the 89th power. Wait a minute. 2 times 10 to the 89th power in population? There's not enough space in the entire universe for that many human bodies. In the entire universe, we only have 10 to the 80th power of electrons. That's in the technical scientific literature. I'm trying to say that when you remove the tapestry, the presuppositions, when you remove the propaganda, the sleight of hand manipulation, when you remove it all, take the bare scientific facts, science still supports recent creation. But let's bring this to a climax by coming closer to home. As we do, we find that an increasing dysfunction of the infant human brain is now demonstrated. Do you realize that in the United States, statistics have now been released showing that one out of every 50 newborns, one out of every 50, has some form of autism. The environment, the genetic instability, the genetic deterioration, all factor in. We now are experiencing an epidemic of global proportions, and the stats are kept and released in the free press. In the United States, we have an epidemic of global proportions, dysfunction of the infant human brain. You trace that back to when it functioned better. You trace it back when it functioned optimally, and that gives you a recent calculation. Take it a step beyond that. The increasing dysfunction of the human brain and its degeneration, the infant brain, is now demonstrated in the rapid rise in human genetic disorders. New human genetic disorders have increased at an accelerating pattern in spite of medical and public health advances. This information demonstrates a recent limit to the optimal function of the human body and its supportive environment. So we have our own brains decreasing in their abilities, even though we have new technological advances which will give us advantages throughout the universe, but at the same time our entire bodies are falling apart. Intact biological material, watch closely, science still supports recent creation. DNA and other biological material rapidly decay due to natural radioactivity, mutations, and chemical breakdown. Measurements of the mutation rate of mitochondrial DNA recently forced researchers to revise the age of mitochondrial Eve from 200,000 years down to possibly 6,000 years. Wow, that matches the creation model. In addition to that, Tyrannosaurus rex soft tissue has been found with intact blood vessels and blood cells. In addition to that, diamonds that are supposedly approaching 3 billion years in age have been found in secular laboratories, have been found to host carbon-14. Carbon-14 has a half-life of approximately 5,600 years. After 7 half-lives, all of it would be gone. The geologic supposition has been that those diamonds were up to 3 billion years in age. But the carbon-14 inside them show that they're only thousands of years old. This assessment of the data leads us to conclude that if you take the real science, we've not been here that long. The universe is young. It matches the model, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Now, would you like to know that God? Since we now know that He did it, evolution did not produce it. Since we now know that we must give an account to Him, it would be very profitable if you are an astute individual with a logical assimilation of data, logical conclusion for the facts of your life and the course of your life. It would be wise if you let the Embracer actually confront you. He is the Embracer. Literally, the Bible states Christ knocks at the heart's door. He embraces us. He said, Adam, where art thou? Now, where are you? Literally, Christ died for our sins. He was buried. He rose again the third day. He is alive, embracing you right now. Would you let Him in? Would you just bow your head and pray this simple prayer? Just pray this simple prayer with me. Dear God, I realize that You are the creator of the universe. I don't understand it all, but I realize that science supports recent creation. And I realize that You're my creator. Thank You for sending Jesus to die for me. Lord Jesus, right now, I open my heart to You. Right now, step into my heart and live. And I will serve You with all my heart. If you prayed that simple prayer, the Embracer, the Creator, the God of the universe, stepped into your heart. Welcome home.
Creation in the 21st Century has been sponsored by Trinity Broadcasting Network. And only with your love gift of support can this program stay on the air. So write to Creation in the 21st Century, P.O. Box A, Santa Ana, California, 92711.
Creation in the 21st Century is a unique program on TBN combining biblical knowledge with scientific verification. Much of the information that I use on the program is available. Contact us. Just write Creation Evidence Museum, P.O. Box 309, Glen Rose, Texas, 76043, or call us at 254-897-3200. We look forward to hearing from you today.